There's a way to improve your immune system function that nobody ever really talks about, and that is by improving the health of your thymus. That's right, you've probably never heard of that, but it is something that is very important for your overall immune response. We're going to dive into the details of this and how you can improve thymus function today. But before we get started, I'm Dr. Nick Zaroski, and welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and if you want to see all my natural health videos, go over to www.drz.tv. I also would highly encourage you to go and become a member on Dr. Z TV because we put lots of great information up there as to how you can improve your health. Recently, we added a full download as to how you can actually fight respiratory infections, nebulizing hydrogen peroxide, improve your lung health by nebulizing glutathione. So you can find all that information when you become a member over at drz.tv. There'll be a link in the description below. Now let's jump into the thymus. What do you have to do to improve your thymus function? Well, let's first get a decent understanding as to what your thymus is. So the thymus is a gland located directly behind your sternum and between your lungs. And it's only highly active until puberty. Pretty interesting. So let's look at what it does. After puberty, the thymus starts to slowly shrink and become replaced by fat. Thymusin is a hormone of the thymus, and it stimulates the development of disease-fighting T cells. I'm going to read through just basically a brief understanding as to what this can do for your overall health. The thymus gland will not function throughout your full lifetime, but it has a big responsibility when it's active, helping the body protect itself against autoimmunity, which occurs when the immune system turns against itself. Therefore, the thymus plays a vital role in the lymphatic system and endocrine system. Now, this is pretty interesting because it's believed that the thymus is actually functioning much longer than it was originally thought to have functioned, meaning that, you know, a lot of times in the past, it was looked at as if your thymus was going to quit working when you were maybe like 30, 40 years old. But some new science shows that your thymus actually will work for a long period of time, even up to your 75 years old. And it's important to make sure it's functioning properly. Now, your thymus is very important. Now, this article already mentioned autoimmunity, and it's important to understand that children very rarely suffer from autoimmunity, and one of the reasons is because their thymus is functioning at a very high level. Before birth and throughout childhood, the thymus is instrumental in the production and maturation of the T lymphocytes or T cells, a specific type of white blood cell that protects the body from certain threats, including viruses and infections. Pay attention to that part because this is going to be very important as we move forward. The thymus produces and secretes thymusin, a hormone necessary for T cell development and production. The thymus is special in that, unlike most organs, it is its largest in children. Once you reach puberty, the thymus starts to slowly shrink and become replaced by fat. By age 75, the thymus is little more than fatty tissue, but that's not to say that it completely dies off at 75. Okay, so as we look at the thymus, at this point, we understand it's a lymphoid endocrine gland. It's active in early childhood, and it's building up. It's setting up your immune system. After puberty, it wanes, but science shows that it's still very important at keeping your immune system balanced. As we look at the thymus, well, there just happens to be a virus out there that people are struggling with, right? And this is very interesting because I recently heard a vaccinologist go and talk about how one of the reasons we have more severe outcomes with elderly versus children when it comes to the virus is simply because of the thymus. Now, of course, there's comorbidities and all kinds of things piled on top of that, but obviously, the thymus plays a huge role in keeping you safe and protected. I'm going to read the abstract to this piece of research here. And this research is called The Role of the Thymus in the VID Disease Severity, okay? Implications for Antibody and Treatment and Immunization. I'm trying to avoid saying the word because I really don't want this video to get taken down, being that I'm giving you advice on alternative therapies for the VID. Now, the thymus is a largely neglected organ, but plays a significant role in regulation of the adaptive immune response. The effect of aging on the thymus and the immune senescence is well established, and the resulting inflammaging is found to be implicated in the development of many chronic diseases, including atherosclerosis, hypertension, and type 2 diabetes. Okay, so basically what they're saying is that as your thymus doesn't work as well because you're aging, you're going to have inflammaging, which basically means more inflammation as you age, and that is correlated with a lot of these inflammatory conditions. Both aging and disease of inflammaging are associated with severe and a dysfunctional thymus may be predisposing factor. In addition, insults on the thymus during childhood may lead to abnormal thymic function and may explain severe vid disease among younger individuals. Therefore, measurement of the thymic function may assist when taking care of somebody after they got the virus. Those with poor thymic function may be treated prophylactically with convalescent serum or recombinant antibodies, and they may respond better to high doses. Treatments inducing thymic regeneration may improve patients' overall health and may be incorporated in managing the vid. Okay, so basically what that comes down to is like, look, if we can go and improve thymus function, which I'm going to show you how to do in just a moment, if you can improve thymic function, then you can help protect yourself from the virus. I'm going to move on down this article a little bit, and we're going to look at restoring thymus function to improve the vid prognosis. The average life expectancy has increased substantially in the 1900s. Studies suggest that although there appears to be maximum limit on lifespan, by targeting the biological and genetic and environmental causes of aging, humans can live longer. In the 1900s, the primary cause of death was infection. With the advent of clean water, antimicrobials, the current leading cause of death is cancer. The vid pandemic may reverse this trend, since the vid-related mortality is significantly higher among people 65 or older. Treatments that restore thymic function may suppress inflammation and stop the inflammation related to the vid and therefore prevent severe outcomes. Okay? So basically what we've determined so far, thymic function is very strong in children. This is why children hardly ever have severe outcomes with the vid. I mean, if you look at the actual number, it's, and you were to round it out, it's pretty much 0%, okay? And when you age, thymic function declines. Therefore, you are going to have more inflammation in the body and a greater chance of having a severe outcome the older you are, okay? Now, of course, as we look at protecting yourself from the virus, one of the things you have to understand is that, you know, this is kind of layered on with many things. We've talked on this channel about vitamin D. We've talked about, you know, if you have comorbidities, you make sure that you're working to fight those off and work through them, you know, reduce your hypertension and lose weight and, you know, balance your cholesterol and your blood sugar and all those things. That's very important. But this is another layer, and that's improving thymic function. So what can you do? So you can actually take different nutrients and vitamins that directly target thymic function and therefore improve it. So what I'll do is I'll put a link in the description to one I found. I found one called GT Thymus. This GT Thymus has a whole list of different vitamins, nutrients, RNA, DNA factors that are all directly designed to support your thymic function. So I think that it's something that's very much overlooked overall. And like I said, this came to my mind to actually do a video on this topic after I just heard a vaccinologist talk about it briefly, just breeze over this topic. But it's like, no, this is so important, because if everybody actually went and supported this lymphoid endocrine gland in their body and improved their immune function by improving the function of the thymus, then we'd all be healthier for it. So it's something that we can definitely take into consideration, and we can definitely utilize those specific nutrients that are designed to target it. When we look at a lot of the different data out there, you just basically get a whole bunch of different vitamins and nutrients that all can support this. But like I said, I'll put a link in the description to a formula that I found that's actually designed to directly target it, with a lot of different variables in there that hit it from every angle. So I think it's super cool. And when you go in and you use this targeted nutritional support, here's what it can do for you. It can basically normalize your immune response, right? Because we talked about how, well, it actually stops your body from attacking itself, autoimmunity, the thymus. It will help with acute immune challenges, okay? So if you just have an immune system challenge that pops up, it's gonna help fight that off. It'll help fight off the cold and flu. It'll help fight off the vid, which we just basically came to the conclusion of. It will support both acquired and innate immunity, and it'll also really just be a good general immune boosting support. So check that out, link in the description below. And I hope you like this video. If you like this one, go ahead and check this one out over here next.